Good day mate, in this video we will talk about direct audio processing. Make your sound from this to
this sound. Alright, let's get into it. So what is direct audio processing? So we process our sound, our voice directly into the Windows. Everybody can hear your processed sound, even when you play it with your online friends. So in this video, we will try this software for EQing and your FX rack from your VST or their basic filters. So to install the software, it's pretty easy actually. You just like click next and let it configure itself, and bada bing bada boom, you got the software itself already set up. Okay, easy, very easy. So in this episode I will show you how to configure the software itself. Okay, we don't need to use the piece audio interface itself, we just need to use the editor, the VST or the FX racks on the software to process our voice. Okay, let's get into it. So I will monitor my voice with OBS. Okay, as you see here, I will use OBS as my monitor software. In the mic or aux track, I will use monitor only to hear my voice. Okay, check 1 2 3, check 1 2 3. Okay, I hear my voice. So to get to this screen, you need to click the piece shortcut here, right click, open file location, and back it up and create editor shortcut to your desktop. You can easily access the editor interface. Open your editor for the first time. It will say this: Equalizer APO has not been installed on the setup device. In this case, my Zoom H1. The device is applied to microphone Zoom H1, this mic. So I don't need to configure it. So now I will disable all the effects so you can hear my raw voice here. Okay, I will delete everything except the EQ to show you guys how I set up my voice processing in this FX racks. Okay, so you need to download the VST first. Okay, the VST plugin by ReaFir, ReaPlux, link in the description below. Okay, so first of all, I will make sure my voice is pretty clear. You can still hear the noise floor here. Okay, like psst. So I will get rid of it with ReaFir. Okay, ReaFir plugin, VST plugin. I will open it. My ReaFir. Okay, ReaFir standalone. Open panel. So I will check this apply automatically. Okay, so it will automatically apply to my microphone voice. So I will choose the mode to subtract and click automatically build noise profile. First of all, you need to make sure that your edit mode is precise and FFT size is 496, because this is the good number for speed and less artifacts and less noise. I will try to draw my noise profile. So it get rid of the noise of the microphone, okay? But I will make sure this is a pretty minimal compression of the frequency, so you can hear my voice like pretty clear and loud. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Check 1 2 3. Okay, and I will put the ReaFir in the first rack because I need to make sure my voice is pretty clear first before I apply another effects like EQ or compression or the gate. So because I get rid of the noise floor, doesn't mean I get rid of all the noise I don't want. Okay, like mouse clicking, you can still hear the noise clicking. So I will apply noise gate to this effect racks. Plugin, VST plugin, open it, and ReaGate, ReaFir gate. Okay, open panel. I will set my gate threshold to -40. Click apply automatically. Apply. If I click my mouse hard enough, I can still hear it. But normal click you can hear it. Okay? This is good for me. You don't want to overget your voice because it will sound like robotic, not natural. So after getting my voice, I will set the ReaGate to number 2. Okay? Noise suppression, noise gate, and next effect is EQ. Why I don't delete this? Because I will need to set my EQ over and over again, but I will demonstrate it to you guys in the next episode how I EQ my microphone. Okay, the easiest way. So this is my EQ by ReaEQ. You can see the settings here. Okay, you can pause it if you want to replicate my EQ settings. So now the EQ is done. So what's next? We need to make your voice is even. We humans, okay? We're not robot. We talk at the different volume. So we need to even out our volume with compression. I will demonstrate it, guys, with the VST plugin from ReaFir, ReaComp, okay? ReaFir compression. Open panel. So I will set my threshold to minus 18 decibel. And I will set my ratio to 18 to 1 ratio, because this settings is often used by the radio. Okay, this is good for broadcasting voice. If you use the 20 to 1 ratio, it will sound like a hard compression. So I don't want that hard compression. I will use 18 to 1 compression ratio. But all the settings, all the logic in the compression and EQ, we will talk about it in the next episode. Alright, so stay tuned. I compress my voice. Even if I talk like right here, you can still hear my voice is like much more even than before. But you can still hear my voice is pretty quite low. Okay, I will maximize my voice with preamplification or with another software as amplify software and hard limit software. So because I don't want my voice reach beyond minus 3 decibel, okay? Minus 3 decibel is maximum, okay? I will use Loudmax VST plugin. I will browse Loudmax, okay? 64-bit. I will set my maximum volume to minus 3 decibel. Okay, minus 3.1 is okay. And now I will set the threshold when the software will louder my voice. I want the software louder my voice from 10 decibel, okay? 10 decibel and up. Minus 10 decibel and up. Apply automatically. Check. 1, 2, 3. Check. 1, 2, 3. Okay. This is my voice with Loudmax 64-bit. Check. 1, 2, 3. This is my voice after the effects. I will check my OBS. If my sound is proper. Check. 1, 2, 3. Check. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Before. Check. 1, 2, 3. This is my voice before processing. Check. 1, 2, 3. This is my voice after processing. Easy, right? Okay. If you have any question, drop your comment below. And see you in the next one.